Statistics is a relatively new area of mathematics, at least historically speaking, if you compare it to geometry and arithmetic. When we're speaking about statistics, we're usually referring to a set of methods and concepts that are applied to help us understand data. And this is why I think statistics is quite amazing, because it gives mathematics access to explaining the world that was previously the realm of random guessing, baseless claims, or what could be referred to as expert intuition. For example, with statistical methods, we're able to make predictions about the voting patterns of a whole country by just surveying a relatively small sample. And we can uncover evidence for complex relationships between, say, smoking and lung cancer. Without statistics, all we have is anecdotal evidence or the opinion of a few overly confident people in society who speak the loudest. But statistics requires a process, and it's important to have an awareness of this when it comes to any statistics that end up being thrown at us. In general, we start with a research question or a problem, something that we want to be answered. But the way we're going to answer this question is with data, and so we have to make sure that the question is framed in such a way that we can do this. In fact, let's start at the end. Whenever we're thinking of embarking on a statistical study, we need to think of the form of our results. For example, I might be studying water use in Australia, and I want to be able to say something like 30% of Australian adults spend less than 10 minutes showering per day. Or I might want to show a graph that compares these results across different states. Or I might even want to make the argument that showering habits are different and influenced by the local rainfall and drought patterns. So to do this, I have to think about what data I need, and then I have to think about how I can get that data. Is it data that's already available? Can I just contact the water companies and weather stations that have this data? Or is my best bet to survey people and ask them what their showering habits are like? Or am I even in a position to set up an experiment where I could control the conditions and observe how people behave? Probably not in this case. But then, even for surveying people, Australia may not be that big, but it's big enough that I can't ask everyone. And so I need to work out how I can go about collecting data in such a way that I can extrapolate those results to the rest of the population. This is probably the trickiest part. I'll need to think not only about what I ask, but also who has the opportunity to be involved in my study and the sample of participants I survey. So it may seem like we're cheating in a way because we're starting with what we want and then working backwards to decide the study. But this is absolutely necessary because it's pointless to start out with a question, collect data, and then arrive at the end of our study only to realize that we didn't really collect the right data for what we were interested in. In the case of questionnaires or experiments, the design is extremely important because sometimes it's impossible to go back and find things out without starting the study all over again. So what kinds of questions can statistics answer? Well, in general, we think of statistics as serving three purposes: describing a population, then after we have two or more descriptions, we can then compare populations, or looking for a relationship between two or more characteristics of a population. It helps to think of groups and variables. A group or a population can be a particular group of people, but it could also be a group of other things. For instance, we might be a fruit juice manufacturer, and we want to do a study on how many of our juice boxes are defective. So it's the set of things, people, places that we want to make statements about. A variable is a measurable characteristic that can differ for members of the group. If you think of tables of raw data, each row might represent a member of your population, and each column would be one of the variables. Different types of variables will lend themselves to different ways of summarizing them. In general, we classify data as either being numerical or categorical. Sometimes the terms qualitative and quantitative are used. Categorical data typically includes variables that are words, whereas numerical data is usually numbers, but it's not always this simple. For categorical data, we have binary variables such as yes, no to a particular question, like whether someone showers in less than 10 minutes, whether they are currently a student, and so on. This is any variable where we have just two options. Then nominal variables are where we might have a number of different choices, like favorite animal or singer or nationality. But we can also have what are called ordinal variables. These are sets of variables that exist on some kind of scale. It could be scales from strongly agree to strongly disagree, small, medium, or large, anything where the order is important, which makes these similar in some ways to numerical variables. For numerical variables, we can have either discrete or continuous data. Discrete variables can only take a finite number of possibilities, or we might say they're countable. For example, the number of children you have can be 0, 1, 2, and so on, but it wouldn't make sense to say 1.23 or 4/5. It doesn't have to be whole numbers though. Shoe sizes like 6, 6.5, 7 are also discrete because there's no possibility of there being a value or shoe size between two sequential sizes. Classical examples of continuous data are things like height, weight, or time. For any two different heights, there's always a value that makes sense that lies in between. Some people like to think of these two types of variables in terms of a staircase or a ramp. It can get a little philosophical though, because we'll always be limited in the way we measure things. So every continuous variable gets discretized when we measure. For example, to the nearest centimeter, to the nearest number of years, and so on. If numbers aren't used to measure a quantity or count something though, they might be considered to be categorical variables. For example, postcodes are really just labels, so we don't treat them the same way we do numbers when we run analyses. As we'll see next week, the type of data affects how we can summarize it. We'll look at a number of different statistical scenarios this week and consider the data types and the purpose of the investigation. But another thing that you're encouraged to do is start being a little critical when it comes to reading statistics. If you hear something like 40% of cats land on their feet if dropped from 3 stories, you should think about the statistical process and how someone would go about collecting and summarizing that kind of data.